Welcome, friends. Today we're doing a special oracle card reading in ASMR, soft-spoken, so you may need to adjust your volume, get comfy, take a nice deep breath for me. We're going to go ahead and pick three cards, and I want you to gravitate towards one or more of these cards. And in this reading, we're going to discuss a shadow aspect of yourself that needs to be addressed. So go ahead and see which card you resonate with most. Card number one, two, or three. Card number one, and shadow aspect of yourself. There's some shadow aspect of yourself that you're running away from. Don't be afraid to address whatever is going on, okay? There's something that you haven't really felt like you have the ability to fully address, but it's time to step into your own sense of self-worth and self-empowerment. Believe in your ability to overcome any hardships or obstacles that come in your way or that have come in your way. There may be something that's still weighing on your heart, and it is quite the burden to bear. So what I want you to really do is focus on what matters most to you in life and think about the things that bring you joy. Remember that when you are feeling overwhelmed or perhaps even upset by something, that there are things that bring you joy. There are things to continue to fight for, and those are the things that matter most. So go ahead. It's safe to address those things that are hurting you. I want you to face them and let the tears flow. Let the energy come out. It needs to be released in order to heal. That's going to facilitate the work that needs to start, and you can start to address those shadow aspects of yourself that you've been neglecting. If you chose card number two. Sorry, all of these are upside down. Card number two is a feeling of aloneness. There's a feeling of somehow not being worthy or not being good enough. This is a card that's reminding you that you absolutely are good enough. You are worthy of receiving the love, the abundance and prosperity and good fortune that the universe has to give you. And there are so many talented gifts that you have to share with the world. This is a beautiful time for introspection and to really maybe do some healing through something like writing or creating. So get into a creative flow and maybe start to let the words come out, pen to paper, and allow yourself to embrace the dark parts of yourself as well as the light. Allow yourself to feel just whatever you feel. Allow it to all come up naturally. Loneliness is natural as well, and feeling lonely is a natural part of life. But this is something that's been really hard for you in particular. And perhaps if you're feeling that way today, it's a good time to reach out to someone you used to talk to. Maybe you've lost contact with someone, but catching up with them and being in touch with them can be so helpful for helping you move forward with that. And I really want that for you. So do reach out to someone. Make new friends. Be open to new connections as well. I feel like online there's a really nice sort of community that people can build here on YouTube and even on other social media platforms, where we can feel like we finally have met people that we feel like understand us and feel like they understand what we can't express. It's even hard for me to get the words out right now. It's almost like a feeling of stuckness, but I feel like once you start being more open and vulnerable with others, it's going to help attract those relationships to start to form and then really grow. So embrace reaching out to people, connecting with people, and doing all you can to embrace that lonely inner child and give them the love, the friendship that they're needing. And be your own best friend too. You know, that's so underwhelming to hear, I'm sure, but you have to be your own best friend. And sometimes the voices in our head can be anything but kind. So if you've been a little mean to yourself lately, that's part of your shadow self that you'll want to address and work on. Ask yourself why it is, and ask yourself how you can work on embracing positivity and saying nice things to yourself. Go look in the mirror and tell yourself you're friggin' awesome, because you are. All right, and if you chose card number three, it is this beautiful maiden. Okay, she's a little sexy and sultry, but she's also demure, and she's got an innocence behind her eyes. It's almost like she has a secret that she doesn't want anyone to know. So this can represent a part of your shadow self as well. There's something that you're not comfortable expressing with others, but there's a silent sort of pain behind your eyes. And others can sometimes see it and sense it, but it is completely up to you if you want to share certain things with people or if you feel more comfortable keeping certain things to yourself. And I feel like you should always trust in your intuition when it comes to that, especially because opening up about our deepest, darkest secrets can be so scary and terrifying, even in relationships that we've had with people for years. So there is a silent sort of pain that needs to be addressed here. I want you to really tap into that feeling, allow yourself to feel it, allow the healing to take place. Maybe work with some black tourmaline because that'll help to absorb any negativity. It'll help to release and to surrender to spirit. I feel like this is a time where you really need to put your trust in the universe and in whatever it is you believe spiritually. Maybe there are certain deities that you connect with, or maybe you just want to be more aligned with your own higher self and your own intuition. So trust in that and know that your secrets are okay. It's okay to keep some things to yourself, and it's okay to be mysterious, and sometimes that's a good thing. So you are beautiful inside and out. You are worthy of everything that you want and that you need in life. You're worthy of so much, especially love, and I want you to take that with you today. All of you who have shadow work to do, which is all of us because we're all humans, we all have gifts to share, and I hope that this reading has helped you to remember that even the dark parts of ourselves are beautiful and worth loving. They are some of the things that make us who we are. They build our characters, they make us strong, they give us strength to carry on and to wake up another day and to fight the fight, you know? So I really, really appreciate you guys listening and being here, and I hope the message is received and that you enjoyed it, and I will be back for another reading tomorrow. So subscribe, like, do all the YouTube-y things, and I'll see you guys in the next one.